Hi, I'm Amy from the Altie store. There's a lot of wrong information about solar out here on the internet. I thought I'd take a moment to correct some of the incorrect myths floating out there. Myth number 5. Solar panels are not environmentally friendly. It takes more power to make them than they save, and then they wear out and have to be replaced often. The embodied energy is the energy consumed to make, deliver, and install a product. That includes mining the materials, processing them, building the equipment, and shipping it to wherever it ends up being installed. First, let me say that most solar panels have a 20 to 25 year warranty. They're guaranteed to still produce at least 80% of their initial power after that length of time. How many things that you bought 20 years ago are still working to 80% of their ability? Solar panels will, and they will continue to work producing clean energy for many more years after that. Grid tie inverters usually have a 10 to 20 year warranty. It is expected they will likely need to be replaced once in the life of a grid tie solar system. Taking all that into consideration, the energy payback time for a grid tie solar system, including the solar panels, inverter, racking, and cables, is around 1 to 2 years, depending on where you are in the world. For a system that should last much more than 25 years, that's a lot of clean energy years. If you look at this with a battery-based system, the numbers can change a bit, depending on the type of batteries used. For example, if you use Aquion salt water batteries, their cradle-to-cradle certification shows that they have minimal impact from creation to recycling. Now, I'm combining myths 4 and 3. Solar is only for tree-hugging, patchouli-sniffing hippies, and solar is only for the rich. Solar power benefits all walks of life. Depending on your location and local incentives available, your return on investment can be as low as 5 years. For example, if you get a 5,000-watt grid-tie solar system, depending on your location, it could produce an average of 500 kilowatt-hours a month. If you buy your system outright, you could be saving over $1,000 a year. That's over $40,000 for the life of your solar system. Now, if you don't have the cash up front to install solar, there are solar loans available that have low interest rates. If you're in a good location for solar, even when including interest rates for the loan, you can still have a good payback time. For example, with that same 5,000-watt system we just talked about, with a 5% solar loan, if you currently pay 13 cents per kilowatt hour, you'd pay $65 a month for that electricity from the electric company. With solar, instead, you'd make the loan payments of $62 a month. Okay, so your savings is only $3 a month to start with. But as your electric rates go up, and they usually do, but your loan payment stays the same, you start seeing more and more savings. Over the life of a 20-year loan, you could have saved $11,000. After that loan is paid off, your system is still making free power, saving you another $24,000 over the next 10 years, all while producing clean energy. Solar power is even good for people who don't install solar, as it reduces the amount of dirty energy that has to be produced, resulting in cleaner air for all. Combined with conservation, it also reduces the number of new traditional power plants that the electric company has to build. To see how we got all these numbers, check out our blog on leasing versus buying solar. Myth number 2. Putting solar on my roof will decrease my property value or bring down the neighborhood. Quite the opposite is true. Multiple studies have shown that if you buy a solar system to install at your house, your property value actually goes up. One study in particular showed that every watt of solar installed increased the resale value by about $4 a watt, as long as it is not a leased solar system. Studies have shown that leased solar systems can actually make the property more difficult to sell, as you need to find a buyer who is willing to take over that lease. It's also been proven that homeowners who have neighbors that already have solar on their house are far more likely to install solar on their own house. It's partly due to keeping up with the Joneses, but also because they don't have to worry about being the first to take the plunge. Somebody else already did it and proved it was a good idea. And the number 1 myth. If I don't have a sunny, south-facing roof, I can't do solar. Whenever somebody talks about installing solar, the southern roof, or northern roof for my southern hemisphere viewers, it's the first place that people think of. But there are other options. If your roof's ridgeline travels north-south, then you may have the ability to install the solar array on the east and west roofs. The eastern array will get lots of sun in the morning, and the western array will get longer energy production in the afternoon. Some utilities are actually incentivizing their customers to install western arrays to help produce power later in the day when the energy loads rise as people are returning from work and school. Now, roofs are not the only place to install solar. An awning mount on a southern wall may also be an option. Or, if you have some space on your property available, you could install a pole or ground mount, or even build a purpose-designed structure like a carport, pergola, or shed. Think outside the box, or the roof. I hope you found this helpful. If so, give us a like and a share, and be sure to subscribe to our Alti Store channel so we can notify you when we have more videos coming out. And please visit our website at altistore.com, where we've been making renewable doable since 1999.